I'm Nathan Go, and this is my story. Wasn't that hard at all, because but it was accepting myself as a gay man, but a gay Christian man, so Christian gay man. So that was the hardest. So I joined this group called Living Waters in the church to help me reconcile my faith, sexuality, by going through the pro-gay and anti-gay argument. And I wasn't convinced, but what really convinced me was when I see how gay men can, Christian gay men can love each other, and how, as a Christian, how I feel God's presence and God's love through their actions, through our works, louder than words, and so after that, I slowly came out. Nowadays, I try to make it an effort to, if people ask, I'll say. So I was out in my polytechnic, and it's so that I make sure that people around me, if they need help, they can come out to me and feel comfortable. And actually, I think every single class I've been to so far, there was a lesbian. Every time it's a lesbian, they come out to me. And the gay men hate me as usual. That's true. The people gave me the most shit was the gay men, because it was so closeted. So, yeah.
Okay,
alright. Awkward
silence,
awkward
silence. Do you think it is a sin to be gay in Singapore?
Sin as sin? I think you're talking about a more religious concept, or you're talking about as a moral thing.
Moral thing.
Of course not. It's definitely not a sin, not a crime. I think gay people, people don't realize that that we are very much really like that. We love, we fuck up, and we have the same problems. And although we are more dramatic, but and I think people, when they comment that homosexuality is wrong, it's a sin, I feel that they don't understand gay people and they don't try to interact. And that's a very dangerous thing, because even back then, when I was being counseled by my leaders in church, this 17-year-old, 18-year-old man who has no experience with gay people at all, they paint a picture that was, they say that gay community is just about sex, drugs, clubbing, and orgies, and there's no true love, but they don't even really interact or talk to gay people. And they comment out of their ignorance and just based on whatever information that they are fed. And I think the newspaper in Singapore that's controlled by the one is not very. They always paint gay people in a very negative light. So you always see like some old man molesting kids, and there was never. I don't ever see a positive story of like gay couple, building houses together or doing community work or something like that. So yeah. So thank you guys for coming so much. Thank you.